Hello everyone, this is Sandeep. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to discuss about care and culture of a beautiful species Dendrobium, that is Dendrobium lindley or Dendrobium aggregatum. But before that, I will tell you something about this species in short. Here is the plant in its full glory. Near about 15 spikes are there. Flowers are bright yellow with a deeper colored leaf. You can see 10 to 12 flowers in a spike, about 10 inch to 12 inch long. Blooming season in spring, mainly in the March. Flowers are mild fragrant like beeswax. They may last for 1 to 2 weeks or little more. Dendrobium lindley is a plant that belongs to a special section of Dendrobium, which is Calista section. The word Calista comes from the Greek word Kalistos, which means very beautiful, and I think this is the most beautiful of this section. Some of other indigenous are in this group like Dendrobium farmeri, Dendrobium densiflorum, Dendrobium triciflorum, etc. If you follow some rules, this plant will give you a great rewards. Let's see their requirements. First of all, the light requirements. Dendrobium aggregatum needs a lot of filtered indirect sunlight throughout the year. 40 to 50% shade net is enough to grow this species. Sunlight is the key to successfully bloom Dendrobium lindley. And water may be the most crucial element to success with Dendrobium lindley. They love to get wet in the rainy season. Rainfall is good for them. When they are in active growth phase, that means April to September, but watering should be taper off during their rest period, that means November to January. That means November to January is the rest period for Dendrobium lindley, and need regular watering in active growth phase. Generally, its pseudo bulb mature within September. After that, we should generally reduce the water supply and allow the plant to dry between waterings. During November to January, they need regular fertilizer during growth phase. You can use balanced fertilizer like 20-20-20 or any other fertilizer that contain high nitrogen formulation. Not only this, winter rest is also play a vital role to bloom Dendrobium lindley. So this species must be required a winter rest period. Generally November to January they have required rest. At this time they prepare for flowering. No need to fertilize your plant now, only water one or two alternative days, that's enough. This is one of my Dendrobium lindley. I mounted on this wooden piece about 3 years back, and you can see the roots are attached very nicely, and last year it blooms like this. I mounted the plant on this wooden piece with the help of threads, and now plants are well set up, so I can remove the threads. And one more thing is that which type of wooden piece we should choose for Dendrobium lindley. I can say that Dendrobium lindley wants hard wooden piece that they can grip tightly. Now I am removing all the threads, and you can see how stable the plant. These are the old dried flower spike. I did not cut for any reason. So now I am removing all the dried flower spike. So you choose a hard wooden piece for Dendrobium lindley, and no need to add any kind of media like moss, coconut husk or anything else. They can grow only on the wooden piece nicely, so no need to add other mediums. You can pot your lindley in a pot also. Here is the plant I potted in a clay pot. I used only brick pieces to pot this plant, small to medium sized brick pieces, as they need hard medium to grow. It's another plant of Dendrobium lindley. And it's a mother plant. You can see on the right side how it bloomed in this year, how gorgeous you can see. I used here a dripped wooden piece. It's very hard. Plant is growing well on this wooden surface, and any epiphytes can grow well on dripped wooden piece. And sometimes you may see bifoliate leaf on Dendrobium lindley. Here is the example. This is a bifoliate, that means two leaves on a pseudobulb.